So let's get back to the heart of the matter. And it's well established in the literature that there's a strong relationship between heart disease and diabetes. But when it comes to clinical medicine, that relationship becomes rather muddied. And we see that all the time, even today. I have patients that come in that they're diabetic and they don't realize that they have heart disease. And on the other side, we have heart patients that don't realize that they're diabetic. And even worse, their doctors, their clinicians are absolutely clueless. So you might ask, why is there this disconnect? Well, welcome to the Framingham distraction. So yes, that's Framingham, Massachusetts. We're back in the 1940s. They tracked the population for decades to see which one has heart attacks and which ones didn't. And then they tracked other things that seemed to be negatively associated, and they called them risk factors. And of course, we know them today as things such as bad cholesterol, smoking, hypertension, diabetes. And since the original Framingham work, they've come up now with guidelines, tools, and risk calculators, all with the central theme to lower cholesterol. And therein lies the problem. It doesn't address metabolic disease. It doesn't address hormonal dysregulation. And it doesn't properly measure for diabetes. This approach misses the mark.